Hello everyone, welcome to again chemistry class. So in today's class we are going to discuss the salt analysis method. So in salt analysis method, first we are going to do a preliminary reactions. So in that, one of the method is action of heating. So based on the appearance also we can identify. So if we did not get based on the appearance given the salt is what, then we will go for action of heating. So in this action of heating, we must take the small amount of small quantity of given salt in a clean test tube, and gently we must heat it by using either a spirit lamp or a Bunsen burner. So when we heat, we get a different reactions. So based on that reactions or based on the vapors or a smell, we can identify the given salt is what. Let's see now. Okay. So when we heat that salt in the test tube gently, so if suppose if we get a colorless gas and a pungent smell. Pungent smell is nothing but something like a bad smell, odor. Okay. So if we get that pungent smell, and when we take the litmus paper, that is a red litmus, and we place to the mouth of the test tube, then the red litmus turns to blue color. If this is the case, then we can confirm that the given salt is ammonium, that is NH4. Then next, one more condition. So when we heat this salt, then if the reddish brown vapors are evolved, and if then acidified ferrous sulfate paper, when we keep to the mouth of the test tube, if the paper turns into brown color, then we can confirm that the given salt is nitrite, NO3. And one more condition, if when before we heat this salt, the salt will be in the white color. That means in the cold condition, salt was white. After we heat, if the color is changed, that means when it is hot, if the color changes to yellow color, then we can confirm the given salt is zinc. So in this way, based on the action of heating, we can confirm whether the given salt is which one. So in the next video, we will go with the next method of preliminary reactions. Thank you.